Ncondezi is a power development company with an integrated thermal coal power plant and mine project in the Tete province of Mozambique. Chief Development Officer Hanno Pengilly is here now. Thanks ever so much for coming in. But first of all, I'd like to know a little bit more about the company, what you do and what you've done to get there in the last couple of years.
Okay, well first, thanks for having us. It's been a while since we've come back to the market and talked, sort of made a big drive to update people on what we're up to. But in summary, everyone is aware of the acute energy shortage situation in Africa. We're talking about, excluding South Africa, you're talking about a region which produces less electricity than Argentina. Whereas most of the world has got access to electricity roughly at about 40% plus, Africa's hovering at about 20%. So it's a clear outlier in terms of its ability to provide large sustainable power to promote social development, economic development, and has become a key focus for all African countries to try and get on top of this. What we're doing is we're operating in a part of the African region, which we believe to be really a market leader, which is Mozambique. You're talking about a country that is the leading power generator after South Africa. It currently exports more power into South Africa than any other Southern African country, but it also plays a more regional role in terms of supplying power into Zimbabwe, Botswana, Zambia, Namibia, and so it's a regional player within this framework of power need. What we really like about the project that we're working on is that it's strategically located in the Tete province, which is where a lot of existing transmission infrastructure currently resides and connects into both the Mozambican grid as well as the Southern African grid. It's at the point where we're connecting into where you can supply both Mozambique, South Africa and the rest of the SADC region. So very strategically located, and I think what's important here is we're looking at a project that's meeting existing demand needs. So this is a problem. We're providing a solution for something that exists today, utilizing infrastructure that is largely in place today.
So you're in the right place at the right time. Tell me a little bit about the team, the brains behind the project.
Well, I think this also is a fairly unique thing that Ncondezi has in terms of a power development project. We have a team that is geared to deliver this project. We're talking about a power plant, a mine, as well as some fairly significant project structuring and financing requirements. And I believe we have the right balance of that expertise between mine, power plant, and structure. And you know, clearly from where we've got to since we signed the Power Framework Agreement in April of 2013 to where we are today, you know, we've delivered on a lot of milestones, and that wouldn't have been possible if we didn't have that broad range of experience within the company.
So you've got the right people on board, but tell me a little bit about the project, because obviously it's an opportunity to run a business in this space right now. But it's going to make a big difference, isn't it, to Mozambique and to South Africa.
Oh, definitely.
Touched on that a little bit.
Transformational, I think, is the right word here. To give you perspective, the part of the grid that we are connecting into currently, there is a power plant generator vessel which is parked off the coast of Mozambique. Supplying 100 megawatts, which is about a third of what we're looking at supplying, but there's a 100 megawatt diesel generator set that's sitting on a boat parked off the coast of Mozambique that is supplying power into the grid at an incredible cost. And you know that power is not only being bought by the Mozambican government, it's being wheeled through Mozambique to supply Zambia. So you know we're talking about a very acute power shortage, and you know it's not enough. You know, the short-term solutions are not affordable. So you know we see our project as being transformational. Certainly the government of Mozambique recognizes the importance of the project. We've had a lot of support from the government of Mozambique. They've made it very clear that they will be looking to offtake 100% of the first 300 megawatts. And they've worked very closely with us to progress the development of the project up to the point where you know we're now in a position where we actually have an agreed tariff with the government of Mozambique. So we have a very good understanding of what the economics of this power plant is looking like. We can't be too open about those economics. These are very sensitive discussions, but you know, I think we've significantly progressed the project to the extent that we now have a major partner in the pipeline in the form of Shanghai Electric Power, which has spent 2 years doing due diligence on the project. And has decided that of the African projects, you know, thermal coal projects in the region, this is the one they want to back. And we're talking about a utility that operates over 100 megawatts of power. To put that into perspective, that's more than the whole sub-Saharan African continent. That's more than the UK produces. That's more than France produces.
It's a good partner to be talking
to. A very good partner. You know, they bring huge amounts of credibility with respect to the fact that they know how to build this thing, they know how to operate this thing. This is their bread and butter, and certainly they have the financing capacity to fund it as well.
I was going to get on to costs. So as you mentioned, that the existing means are not working, they're too expensive. And now you're with a partner who's going to make financing easier. But do you think you're going to need to go to market soon to raise some money to get those next steps done?
Okay, so I think it's very important to break this down in that we have signed a joint development agreement with Shanghai Electric Power, and that agreement was signed in January. We're in the process of making that agreement effective, and that means that it's more a procedural process now. The commercial terms of the deal agreed, they were released in the press release. We really are looking at completing these conditions precedent probably towards the end of September. Once that is done, the transaction with Shanghai Electric Power becomes effective. At that stage, Shanghai Electric Power takes over the management role of the power plant project. They will be investing up to $25 million to fund the project to financial close, so it takes away all the funding risks around the power plant. In addition to that, at financial close, they will be providing 60% of the equity, 100% of the debt. So again, there's a big de-risking element here, and that we've provided the answer on not only who's going to build and operate this thing, but who's going to bring the funding to do it. And Shanghai Electric Power has now committed to that.
So you've got enough cash to do what you need to do without having to go to market to raise funds in the near to medium term?
No, not 100%. We still, you know, the SEP transaction will only cover the power plant related costs. Okay. You know, so it will not cover the mine and the London listed related costs.
And how much might you need for that?
At the moment, we don't see that as a material number, probably a couple million dollars. But the important thing here is that what is it funding? It's funding our listing costs, which are not significant. It's funding our mine development costs, and the mine is already at a very advanced stage. We have our mining concession, we have our environmentals in place. All the land, water, etc. permits are either in place or in final form. So there isn't really a lot of work to do there. Really, it's actually finalizing this coal supply agreement, which will allow the coal mine to supply the power plant. Most importantly about that capital raise is that is not something we're looking to do before the transaction with Shanghai Electric is complete. So we're looking to materially de-risk the project before we raise any additional capital. Likewise, we have been in discussions with a number of different investment parties that are interested in being part of this power project. And all of these discussions will culminate in sort of a final solution post the SEP transaction.
Well, you've got a lot of the licenses and the permits in place. You've mentioned you're quite far along. What are the next steps then?
Well, key next step is to get the transaction with Shanghai Electric Power complete.
And you know, that's, and you're looking at September for that?
End of September is the current target. And really the key driver in all of that process are the final Chinese government approvals. Just to highlight and to give people some comfort, you know, this is a process which has taken 2 years. It's cost Shanghai Electric over $1 million in external due diligence costs on top of their own costs. This is a company that has spent significant time, resources, concluding this deal with us, and it is a state-owned entity. So to some extent, it has had in-principle approvals already. So they are very confident they're going to get these approvals. And you know, we are working very closely with them to make sure we're managing this time frame appropriately. After the Shanghai Electric Power joint venture agreement has become effective, we really then run into the final phase to get the project to financial close. That means completing the key commercial agreements, namely the power purchase agreement, which should be complete by the end of the year. And then we really run into the financing phase, which we're targeting completion by the middle of 2017. At that point, we can then start construction of the power plant. So a very clear pathway over the next 12 months.
And that's when things really will start getting exciting.
Well, I think they're already getting exciting, to be honest with you, in that we've got this partner here. You know, we've got clear milestones now, between now and financial close. you know, we've got the credibility of a Chinese partner that, as I say, can deliver this project, can fund this project. And, you know, a lot of those key risk questions that people have with investment of this nature have now been answered in terms of, as I say, and I'm repeating myself profusely, but, you know, who is going to manage the construction? Who's going to operate? Who's going to fund? And I think we've addressed those questions with the SEP transaction.
So you've addressed those questions, and it's a busy time ahead for you, but then things can, what you're saying, an exciting time to be in the company, a very interesting space to be into. Thanks ever so much for filling us in.
Thanks for having us.